Hi everyone, my name is Lewis from Vev, and today I'm going to be showing you how you can build an annual report in Vev. In recent years, annual reports have transformed from being dry, stagnant communications into engaging content experiences, full of rich visuals, interactivity, and storytelling. And whilst they might look complicated to build at first, with the introduction of no-code tools like Vev, you can create an interactive report just like this without having to write a single line of code. So let's jump into it. So the first thing you want to do is head into Vev and create an account if you haven't done so already. Designing in Vev is completely free, and when you want to go live, all you have to do is purchase a project plan to remove the watermark. Let's start by giving our annual report an eye-catching header. So we can create our first section using the keyboard shortcut K and then clicking onto the canvas. We can then go in and add a text box. Here we'll add our header, we'll write something like year in review, and we'll set this to an H1 tag. We'll also insert a subtitle in the same text box and set this to H2. With the text box selected, we can head over to the design panel here on the right hand side and play around with the fonts to get them looking the way we want them to. Then I'm just going to head up to the constraints tool a bit further up and set this text box to be centered. Next, we're going to change our background color. So if we head over to the design panel on the right hand side and select background, we can pick the color of our choice. Now let's give this section a little bit of life. So if we press M on the keyboard to bring up the add menu, we can search for and select Lottie Animation and then click and drag it onto the canvas. We will then need to double click the element to bring up the contextual menu and upload our .json file. If you have one already, then great. If not, you can get them for free at lottiefiles.com. As you can see, I've added another Lottie animation, and I'm just going to finish off this section by adding a down arrow indicating the flow of the page. With our initial header done, I'm going to add another section underneath, add another large Lottie animation, and also finish it off by adding some big bold lettering with the year. So why not take us back to 1999? We can create a cool effect here by adding another section underneath, making it the same color as our text, and then butting them together to create this cool sort of bleeding effect. So next up, we're gonna give some context to what this annual report is about. So when you create content like this, you wanna make sure that you are telling a story. What's your focus and why are these statistics important? Without any sort of storyline, the user's most likely just gonna get lost in the numbers that you're throwing at them and they're gonna lose interest, and that's definitely not what we want. So I'm just going to drop in a text element with an H2 tag in there, writing something like quite a year. I'm also going to be adding another text box to the right of this. I'm just going to be using lorem ipsum, but you'll be wanting to write in some context to why the reader should be reading your report. Now, just to make our lives easier for when we want to optimize the other devices, we're going to put these two text boxes into an auto layout group. So if we select both of the text boxes and go to the design panel on the right hand side, we'll see auto layout, press the plus, and then we'll also want to select wrap content. Now, with our intro out of the way, we can now start adding some data. Now, there are a few different ways we can use Vev to visualize some of this information. The chart element is an easy way to add some visual data to your project. So we're going to press M on the keyboard to bring up the add menu once more and search for charts, and then click and drag it onto the canvas. By default, the background will be grey, so I'm just going to quickly set the opacity to 0. Okay, so let's double click that chart element to bring up the contextual menu. Here we can select from a variety of different options, the first being what type of chart that we want. The second tab is data. Here we can copy and paste from a CSV file, or we can input our information directly into the spreadsheet. Next we have styling, where we can experiment with the visual style, including the color, the hover color, we can add a border, and we can also have the freedom to change the color per column. Moving on, if we go to axes, we can see that we have a lot of different visual styles to play with here, including the main axes and the minimum and maximum value. For legend, we can turn this on and off, and we'll also have a few different styling options for the font. Last but not least, we have animation, so we can turn the animation on and off, and we can also decide whether we want it to load when it first comes into view, or we can make it react as the user is scrolling with the page. Now that you understand how to use the chart element, you can now build this into your project to create some cool looking visuals. But there's also a few different ways we can get data visualization into our project using third-party resources. If we open up the add menu once more, there's a couple of options here that we have to play with.
The first is the Flourish element, where all you have to do is upload the URL link to your Flourish project, and the second is embed anything, where you just need to input the embed code.
Now, with your newfound knowledge on how to add data visualization into your Vev project, you can now create an interesting mix for your annual report. So feel free to add as little or as many of these elements to your project as you see fit. And that's it, you've created your first annual report in Vev. So the annual report that I have created with you today is available as a template if you go into Vev and select Create Project. You can find it in there. You can also go in, dissect it, see how I've made it, but you can also copy and paste elements from this template and add it to your own. So feel free to do that. For more videos like this, you can check out vev.design/learn. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next one.